This was the most asked about question. Thoughts about, you know, my previous relationship. Someone here says, do I still love her? What's up, everyone? Welcome back to Everyday Hustle. Excited to have you guys here. My name is Adam Ali. Since you're here, hit the subscribe button. Thank you again for being here. I have a problem, y'all. The problem is I use this room for a lot of things. I work out of here, I do my podcast from here, I film from here, I record videos for Samia in here, I'm on the phone here, I be tuning onto the TV there, I do a lot of brainstorming here, but the problem here is it gets really loud. I mean, sorry, downstairs, the noise trickles all the way up to this floor and it interrupts my flow because I gotta come out and say, on set, guys, quiet, and I've pretty much figured out, well, I'm hoping that putting some soundproof foam can really help me fix this problem, because even when I'm recording podcasts, you know, and there's cars sometimes flying by and it just gets out of hand. So it's time to find a solution to this. They've been compressed for transportation reasons, smart. But what I'll do is start placing them around the door area. Hopefully that bounces off some sound so that way I can record in peace. While I'm setting this all up, I'm doing a Q&A, okay? Shout out to everyone who sent me questions. I put a Q&A call out on my YouTube community. I don't know if you've ever been to YouTube. Every channel, for the most part, has a community page where I can post images, people can comment, I can do polls, etc. You guys should check that out. I'll actually link it in the description. But shout out to everyone who left me questions. While I'm setting this up, I'm gonna be answering some of those questions. So let's get this day going. All right, so the first question here is, what is my opinion on going into business with your significant other? Do you recommend it? And if not, why? Woohoo! I could definitely speak intelligently about this because, as you probably know, I went into partnership with my former spouse. And did it put a strain in our relationship? Absolutely. The strain was I had to wear many hats. And what that means is, beyond just being a husband, I was also a manager, an accountant. I was playing all these facets, all these hats, and I was the bearer of good and bad news, and most of the time, news that required a lot of pressure. Like, hey, this is due, you know, and it becomes a point where you start thinking, like, you start looking at your partner as some sort of authority. Is that gonna be the situation for everybody? No, because what happened in this scenario that, you know, that involves me is there was a loss of understanding of what this is all about. You know, it just became focusing on the work versus like, hey, it's beyond just work. You know what I'm saying? When you lose your why, then these type of things happen. And do I recommend it? I think as long as you're on the same page, I really think that if you find a partner that is by your side, then you found gold. Someone that truly believes in you, who's willing to show up as much as you, or even sometimes, or even more. That is dream, to build an empire with your significant other. So it really depends on the, you know, the communication, the goals. There is no right or wrong answer. I'm just giving you guys a little bit of both sides. I think it's a beautiful thing. But when someone loses the why and they're just looking at the task or looking at that person as just, here he comes again, or here she comes again, about to delegate me some tasks, and forgetting like, hey, no, like, we're in this together. You're the face. I'm not saying I'm the brains, but I am connecting the dots behind the scenes. And once we understand that always, and we know what our goals are, then it's all good. It's beautiful. Anyhow, on to the next question. So Christine said, what do you think is the first step when starting a skincare business? I want to start my own business in skincare, but would love some advice. I would say you got to ask yourself the tough questions, especially females, okay? Let me tell y'all something. PSA to all the females out there that want to do business and that have partners specifically. Your partner is the first line of defense to ask you the tough questions to your ideas. A lot of time you interpret that as negative, or that person is being, I don't want to say a hater, but you're looking at it from a negative angle. Their role is to ask you the tough questions so you do the research and really understand that this is what you want to do, all right? So your friends, your significant other, when they ask you that tough question and you feel like you can't answer it, then you haven't done the homework, or you're not willing, like you're focusing on the wrong things. You're just focused on like, why is this person asking me these tough questions? My idea, my passion for this is what I wanna do. No, these tough questions are gonna guide you, okay? If you have someone who's asking you these tough questions, I think that's the very first step to understand, you know, to help guide you. A lot of time the idea is there, but you need some guide and directions. Once you have those tough questions being asked and you're able to answer them, that's the first step to figuring out what direction to take and everything. All right, here we have, as a recently separated father, you have a lot of plates, co-parenting, business, YouTube, etc. What advice can you give on keeping all these plates spinning? You gotta be super organized. I think also self-care too is essential. As you guys will see, I'm always just taking care of my mind, taking care of my fitness, my health is priority. And then yeah, back to just being extremely organized. I'm tedious when it comes to being organized. I know what I need to do on the personal side. I know what I need to do on the business side. Just mapping out everything, be as strategic as possible, because you wanna have control of your life, and you only have control of your life when it's mapped out. If you don't have control of your life, then you know what that looks like? You're just in reaction mode. Someone emails you, then you're reacting. And someone calls you, then you're reacting. You're forever in reaction mode. You don't have a grip of your life because there's just no set action plan. So the first thing I would say is to certainly have an organized system that works for you. Someone asked me, would I ever consider going back to Canada?
Well, let me say that I am a product of Canada. I think it's a great time to rep Canada, to be from Canada. Clearly, we on our shits, you feel me?
I think Toronto runs the game, to be honest. I mean, if you really break it down, we got The Weeknd, we got Drake, we got Tory Lanez, we got Justin Bieber, we got Party Next Door. I can go on and on. And even from a creator side, you know how much creators come out of there? We're booming. But the problem with Canada is such a small market. One of the major reasons why we left Canada was we felt like we were capped at what we were trying to do. And America is just such a bigger market. As you guys can see, like I work with brands on a consistent basis. That was not the case back in Canada. And there's just a little bit more opportunities. Of course, you know, there's a little madness here, but as of right now, I don't see myself positioning myself there right now. Shout out to Toronto, shout out to the Six. I'm forever repping. What's that line by Drake? Never home, hardly home, but always repping. Yeah, I got a lot of ties to Toronto. Got business operations going on over there. I'll be checking in and out as per usual. Just to follow up on that, someone asked, what are my thoughts about Georgia? Like, what do I like about it? Georgia, well, number one, you definitely get more value for your money in this state, that's for sure. I think, you know, specifically, if you're a Black creator, this is a great hub to be, just because there's a lot of people that look like you here who are striving. But I do think that my personality has always been to bring people together. I did that in Toronto, and I will do that here in Atlanta. Just bringing like-minded individuals together, creating. Is something that this city still lacks. Even though there's a lot of people and everybody's operating their own silo, no one has really connected them together. Hopefully I play a role in that, because I'm cool with a lot of creators. It's always love. I got no drama with nobody. It's always love when you see me. I like Georgia because, again, like I said, you got a lot of people that look like me doing it. Last question. This was the most asked about question. Thoughts about, you know, my previous relationship. Someone here says, do I still love her? Are we still together? Let me just say this. If I was mad, then it would be fixable. At the end of the day, you got to boil down and think about what really matters. You're mad at this very situation, then there's hope, you know, because you're going to have to get over that after you're mad. Eventually, you can't be mad forever. That's so draining. But the question is, do I respect the person? There's a fundamental difference between being mad and not respecting someone no more. And I think it's severed. Like, there's no respect on both sides, it appears. It's just a no for me. So yeah, I'm experimenting on this channel. That's my first Q&A. If y'all liked the Q&A, I'll do it in a future episode. Comment below, maybe some additional questions, or if you liked this segment, and hopefully I can add it. I'm just experimenting. I'm trying to figure out elements that I can add to the channel to improve the experience for you guys. Anyhow,
Let's have a blessed day. A lot of times you gotta do professional for this. You're it. Y'all, I am going to the bank really quick. I'm opening up a bank account for Samia, all right? I think it's important that the kids get exposed to just financial literacy, you know? There's things they learn as children. They learn how to play in the park, they do this. And I think, you know, a great stepping stone to their success is exposing them to, you know, finances. So I'm gonna be taking her to a bank. I'm gonna be opening up an account for her. And hopefully that, you know, embeds the idea of saving. You know, you need to put effort before you get something. Not everything just materializes because you have parents. You wanna instill that from now. So we're gonna head over to the bank and open up her first bank account. Let's go. Hey, you ready to open up your bank account? Say cha-ching.
Cha-ching.
Why are you acting like this? Let's go.
Okay.
Hey, Aya Papaya. Nom, nom. Nom, nom. You see this face? She's so edible.
Look.
Zeno. We're gonna open up a bank account for you next month.
Bye, Sammy, I love you.
All right, bright and early. Most likely, I won't be able to record inside, but I have the appointment, so we're gonna open up the account, and that's gonna be exciting. I'm in a new vehicle here. I'm in a rental right now. My car's in the body shop. I'm changing up a few things with the car, so I'm excited for that. But anyhow, Samia, ready to have a bank account?
Yeah.
Okay, say cha-ching. Cha-ching.
Cha-ching.
Cha-ching.
Eh?
All right, that's all done. Now I gotta head over to the UPS to drop off 100 beard oils. Let's go. All right, y'all, just wrapped up being at the bank with Samia. That was a cool experience. Like I said, I'm about to drop off a bunch of beard oils that's going to Canada. I'm excited to get them to the six. What else I got going on? A little self-care in a bit. Gonna head over and do the hyperbaric oxygen chamber. There's been a lot of benefits around the hyperbaric oxygen therapy, such as anti-aging. So your boy about to turn into Bart Simpson. And then, you know, Everyday House, I got a bunch of things going on, man, today. So of course you guys gonna take this ride with me. Morning, everyone. Hope you guys are blessed. Thank you for stopping by. If you don't know, if you're new here, my name is Adam. I'm starting the day off with self-care, okay? I go to this spot right here called Restore, just like the name. It's just all about restoration, you know, getting your health back. I do cryotherapy here. Cryotherapy is something, is like this chamber you walk in, it's like super cold, and it helps with inflammation and recovery. It's like a minus 190. Anyhow, today I'm gonna be doing something called the hyperbaric oxygen chamber. There's been a lot of new studies that have been showing that it helps with anti-aging, you feel me? But you gotta do like multiple sessions. So this is my first day of turning back into Bart Simpson. So I'm hopefully after 10 sessions, I will be a baby all over again. But anyhow, no, oxygen is life, you know what I mean? So if you got a lot of oxygen coming back at you, concentrated oxygen, it definitely helps with recovery, helps with restoring and repair, call it, you know, your skin. So yeah, I'm gonna take you guys behind the scenes of doing that. Gotta wear a mask. Yeah, so what's it officially called? The hyperbaric oxygen chamber? What is it?
Yeah.
That's it? Really, yeah, the nurses see my veins and they're like, oh, that's the dream.
It is.
Thank you. See y'all in Mars. I'm going to Mars. Okay, that wasn't bad at all. Do I feel any benefits? No, not yet, but from my understanding, you gotta do like 10 sessions till you get to see some real benefits. So I won't be turning to Bart Simpson right now, but hopefully after 10 sessions or so. But it was good overall.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how extra am I? You know, I have to get this head mask because I'm allergic to nonsense and BS. So moving on forward, I just gotta wear a head mask. Anyhow, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Look out for my funny Instagram post where I'm gonna be wearing my head mask. A lot happened today. I appreciate you guys sticking with me throughout the day. Be sure to comment, like, and subscribe. And catch you guys in the next video. Peace.